It is the hour of what, about 9:46, and having arrived, I'd like to call the Kane County Board meeting of April 13th to order. Clerk, could you please call the roll call?
Allen? Bates?
Bates here.
Berman? Berman here. Brown?
Here.
Davist? Ford?
Here.
Davist here. Mute button stuck.
Fraz?
Fraz here.
Gums?
Gums here.
Iqbal?
Iqbal present.
Kenyon?
Here.
Caius?
Caius present.
Kopi? Leonard?
Leonard here.
Lewis?
Lewis here.
Martin?
Martin present.
Molina?
Molina present.
Sanchez?
Here.
Shepro?
Shepro present.
Silva?
Silva here.
Strathman?
Strathman here.
Sergis? Tepe?
Tepe here.
Weber?
Weber present.
Winicky?
Winicky present.
Chairman, you have a quorum.
Fantastic, thank you. Before we begin with the Pledge of Allegiance, I just wanted to share something with you. Every time I walk into this room and I see all of you here for a board meeting, I have to pause and I feel so honored, truly honored to be part of all of you. It is a wonderful responsibility and it is with privilege and actual joy that I'm serving in this capacity. So I just wanted to share that with you. I hope you all feel the same, especially all of our newly elected board members and a state's attorney. It's an amazing responsibility that we all have. And I want to thank you for sharing your knowledge with us and your insights as we move forward governing Kane County. So good morning. So could we please have the Pledge of Allegiance? I believe it's Mr. Sergis who's going to be sharing that information. Where is Cliff? Cliff, do you have a guest who you're going to be doing it, or are you going to be leading it for us? Perfect.
Pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America.
And to the republic for which it stands, one nation under
God, indivisible, liberty
and justice for all.
And now we need the invocation.
Today in the COVID environment, trying to figure out who was Zooming and who was coming face to face. I am happy to lead that.
Yes, sir, please do so.
Okay. Father God, we are humbled today that you bring us together as we begin to advance out of this pandemic, and we hope and pray that you instill among us a sense of morality and a sense of fair play and a sense of responsibility that we might govern for all those constituents that gave us their power. Holy name we pray. Amen.
Okay. Thank you very much. May I have the approval of the March 9th and March 24th minutes? Is there a motion to approve?
Caius move.
Caius in a second.
Gums seconds.
Who seconds?
Sorry. Who?
Gums.
Mr. Berman, please. Are there any thoughts or comments on the minutes changes? Hearing none, please call the roll.
Allen? Bates?
Bates, aye.
Berman?
Berman, yes.
Brown?
Yes.
Davist?
Davist, yes.
Ford?
Yes.
Fraz?
Yes.
Gums?
Yes.
Iqbal?
Iqbal, yes.
Kenyon?
Yes.
Caius?
Caius, yes.
Kopi, did you arrive? Leonard?
Leonard, yes.
Lewis?
Lewis, yes.
Martin?
Martin, yes.
Molina?
Molina, yes.
Sanchez?
Yes.
Shepro?
Shepro, yes.
Silva?
Silva, yes.
Strathman?
Strathman, yes.
Sergis? Sergis, yes. Tepe?
Yes.
Weber?
Yes.
Winicky?
Yes. Excuse me, yes.
Thank you. Could I just make a comment to all of our board members who are online? If you have a camera, can you please turn it on so we can see you? It's hard for me to have you be part of the, thank you, meeting without having actually participating virtually is fine, but it'd be great to have your faces up there as well.
Hi.
There we go. Good morning. Thank you. Pajamas are welcome. That's fine.
Give me 1 minute.
Are we all good? So I believe there may be public comment. As a matter of protocol, we ask that the speakers refrain from any statements or remarks or conduct that may become disruptive to the conduct of the county board or which may cause a disturbance. I have one individual that I know has signed up. Are there anybody else? Or is there anybody else? No? Mr. Chauncey Kirkland, would you like to speak now or would you like?
I believe he was having trouble signing in. I just sent.
Okay. Mr. Kirkland is having problems coming on board. So I know he had commented that he would perhaps like to hold his comments until we get to the specific issue that he wanted to address. So we'll put him aside as he's going through trying to get his internet connection to work. So now it's time for my updates. It's been a busy month. I'd like to call out a couple things and I'll go through my notes pretty quickly. First of all, I'd like to commend the fact that this is a 20-year celebration of the Farmland Protection Program here in Kane County. I think it's notable and I do believe that this is one of the few counties that has that kind of program. Isn't that correct?
We were the first and for a long time the only in Illinois that had this. They do it in other parts of the country, but I think some people got on board later on, but we had money.
We have money, yes. And the will, and the will to do it.
Oh, yeah.
And the other thing I would like to also note is that this week, and we'll be approving this resolution, is the National Public Safety Telecommunications Week, Communicators Week. It's our special thanks to our men and women who are there to guide us, to answer our phone calls during our most desperate times, to help us through this until the emergency individual fire department, police department can come actually to help us out. I have used them, and I think we've all used them from at least once or twice in our lifetimes. And they give us courage to move forward. They give us instructions on what to do in trying circumstances. And I don't know how they can do it when you have a screaming woman going, help me, help me. And they guide you through all this, or a man. So they are truly to be commended. Another note regarding public health, you may have heard on the news this morning that the Johnson & Johnson vaccine has been stopped here in the United States. It has been pulled. We have taken quick action, and the Elgin and Aurora vaccination sites, which were scheduled today for the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, have been halted. We will open them back up tomorrow using Pfizer, and we will no longer be using the Johnson & Johnson vaccine until it is reauthorized by the federal government. So it is stopped here in Kane County.
Madam Chair, do you know what that does to our ability to provide some number of shots?
You need your microphone, please.
I was, but Madam Chair, do you know what that's doing to the number of shots that are available for people?
I'm sorry, I still can't hear you, Mr. Tebby.
Do you know what that's doing to the number of shots that are available?
They are going to be rescheduled already. The health department has taken quick action. I was on the phone with them about 7:30 this morning. And they're going to be rescheduling all of those individuals for a Pfizer, the first shot of the Pfizer. So they've already been very proactive with all of this. So it will not stop. And we will continue having the vaccines distributed.
Great.
Madam Chair?
Yes.
Bates, just to reassure people who did get the Johnson & Johnson shot, it was 4 cases of blood clots out of millions of people who received the vaccination. So I appreciate their abundance of caution, and hopefully everybody will be okay.
Yeah, that we are taking quick action and making sure that people are being notified. We'll proceed with caution on that, but I don't want to say anything out of turn because I'm here right now, not being able to see what's going on with the health department. But we'll keep you very much informed of what's happening with the J&J vaccine. We have begun to work and developing with the reapportionment of members for our new reapportionment committee. As you know, this is happening every 10 years, and it's our time now to start doing this. We're going to have 2 special board meetings at the end of this month, which we're going to be talking about what this means, the remapping, actually starting the process of appointing or deciding how many board members you want, if you would like to increase it or decrease the number of board members. That has to be decided first. We'll also be talking about compensation for board members and for the county chair. That is our decision to make, actually your decision to make. We will also be talking about if you'd like to have 2 board members in 1 district. So right now, doing the math, it would be 12 districts with 2 board members in it, or if you'd like to keep it 24 separate districts, or 26, or 22. So that'll be our discussion to have. The one thing that I do want to call your attention to is we're going to have a lengthy discussion on this when we meet, is by state law, we are supposed to use the decennial data, which means the census data. As you are aware, the census data is going to be delayed until September, so we will not get the actual exact numbers that we need to use at that time. Looks like the state of Illinois has agreed to use the American Community Survey, which is a subset of the census data. However, it does not fully collect all the data as completely as the census data does. So it's an estimate of rather than an actual based on fact, as many doors as people could knock. That's going to be a conundrum. So I'm just going to forewarn you on that, on what this is going to look like. We can lobby the state legislature to pass a bill that will push back the election of petitions from September to another appropriate time, and we can analyze the data and make sure we use the proper census data. I'm going to be taking a look at those, what those bills are, and then I'll be working with Michelle Gumbs and Cheryl Strathman to see if we can start pushing that out and asking our state legislators to support that bill. But we have to make sure that the bill suits the county, and all the other counties in Illinois are faced with the same issue. If we want to use estimated data or exact data. So it's a real issue that we're going to be dealing with, but we are asked to use by state law the decennial data. So that's going to be the big problem. But the other things we can certainly work towards, working with the size of the board and working with compensation. So that's something we can control very easily. I also, we're starting to prepare for the celebration. I believe it's the April 30th opening of the Multipurpose Center. It's going to be a great celebration, and I look forward to seeing you all there. It'll be a very happy moment for everyone here. Hard work has been done, and it's going to be an amazing facility. Also, cannabis number, the bill number HB 2415, which will allow Kane County to start receiving its tax revenue for the cannabis tax, was signed by Governor Pritzker on April 2nd, and proceeds from this money will finally be here in Kane County starting in May. So that's exciting. We have a new tax revenue. Once this starts coming in, I would like to ask the board, and maybe we can put it through the Finance Committee for next month, to designate how you'd like to spend this money. What is it for? Is it for farmland protection? Is it for social justice issues? This is something that the board can decide to do or simply put it into the general fund. But if we go through passing the legalization what we've got a couple of agenda items here that we have to approve. If we allow an unincorporated area, adult use cannabis or cannabis related businesses, we'll once again be able to start using that tax revenue for that specific purpose. So that'll be something to consider. And it's our decision on how you'd like to spend that money. And then finally, I'd like to congratulate Steve Ward on his recent win to the St. Charles City Council. It is our great loss, but St. Charles's gain. And he told me during the selection, don't worry if I win, you'll have a friend in St. Charles. Indeed. We will make sure that we lean on you if we need your help. So congratulations.
Steve Weber.
Weber, thank you. That's fine. Not Steve Ward, Steve Weber. Okay, so that finishes my report. Lots of things have been happening upstairs. So now I'd like to move on. I don't think we have any. We have no zoning petitions. Did you see the size of this? This is what we're going through today. So it's time to put this up here. So we have no zoning petitions, I believe.
That's correct. For the first time in my recollection, we have no zoning or subdivision presentations.
It is.
I can make up a couple if people want.
Do you want more? I think this is a ream of paper. I'd like to have a motion now and a second to approve the appointment of the Kane County Reapportionment Task Force.
Second, Berman.
Berman?
Yeah, it's really important that you see it.
Sanchez.
You got a voice at some time. Yeah. Berman,
second. Okay. All right, is there any discussion on this?
Yes, Madam Chair. I was just wondering if we could get the names of those people that are being appointed.
Up and they're right up there.
Look up.
Oh, okay.
They're right there. And it should have been sent to you.
Okay. I
hope it was sent. It was supposed to be sent out yesterday. If not, we'll resend it for sure. This selection of individuals was done on a bipartisan manner, and we tried to ensure that representation was done throughout the county, taking a look at locations. We also took a look at making sure that we had racial parity, ethnic parity was part of that as well as a variety of different jobs. So we have elected officials on there. We have a professor, we have an attorney, we have a mayor, several mayors. So we really tried to do a bipartisan approach to this. And I think it's absolutely a fantastic group of people. And needless to say, all of you, I hope, will be encouraged to attend our meetings as we have them, because it's going to be a very interesting discussion for all of us.
Madam Chair, Shepro.
Yes, Mr. Shepro.
I would second the comments from the chair. Mr. Meyer, I think, has an E after his M. And as was the case with the Treasurer Committee, Madam Chair agreed that Jeff would serve, in effect, as in my stead as the Republican Party Chair. I believe Madam Chair and your Vice Chair will both be active participants in this committee And again, I think we have a mixture of new board members that were part of this process 10 years ago, a mix of municipal leaders from both the urban and rural areas. And I believe that we will be able to, working together, put together an excellent package that will cover all of the many different items that the various laws require us to do, which you will all learn more about next week.
Any other comments?
Motion to approve, or do we already have one?
We've already done that. If there's no other comments, clerk, could you please call the roll?
Allen.
Aye.
Bates.
Bates, aye.
Berman.
Berman, yes.
Brown.
Yes.
Davis.
Davis, yes.
Ford.
Yes.
Fraz.
Yes.
Gums.
Gums, yes.
Iqbal.
Iqbal, yes.
Kenyon.
Yes.
Caius.
Caius, yes.
Kopi, did you ever arrive?
Kopi, yes.
Oh, thank you. All right, Leonard.
Leonard, yes.
Lewis.
Lewis, yes.
Martin.
Martin, yes.
Molina.
Molina, yes.
Sanchez.
Yes.
Shepro.
Shepro, yes.
Silva.
Silva, yes.
Strathman.
Strathman, yes.
Sturgis.
Yes.
Tepe.
Yes.
Weber.
Yes.
Winicky.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you. Now, are there any committee updates?
Madam Chairman, I think you mentioned it already. We're having the multi-use facility opening.
Do you want to talk a little bit about that?
Just to remind everybody, it's on the 30th. So welcome, everybody. Come get your cookie.
Yes, get your cookie.
It's discount coupons for the coroner's office.
Boo.
Since this involves the SWAT team and the bomb squad and the coroner, this is maybe one of your only opportunities to get in and see some of these areas before they're...
With your eyes open.
yeah, while still breathing. So we encourage you to be there. And I'll just add to that, seeing the coroner staff walking through their almost finished facilities, it's so fun because they're just like giddy. And also they just received their two new vehicles. So they're getting probably one of the nicest facilities in the state and a couple of the nicest vehicles you'd ever want. So all the same month. So
fantastic. Pretty cool. Fantastic. The efforts all of you have put into making this building happen are just commendable. And I know the coroner is thrilled. Any other reports? All righty. So let's go to the bulk of our work, approving resolutions and ordinances. Would anyone like to remove an item from the consent agenda?
Yes, I will. Do we need a...
Mr. Berman?
Yes, number
21-188, finance budget. 188. Okay. Yes, Ms. Woodnicki.
Thank you, Ms. Chairman. 21-182.
182?
182.
Two. Mm-hmm. Yes, Mr. Sanchez.
21-208.
Anybody else?
Madam Chairman, was 21-227 removed from that?
No, we have 21-188, 21-182, 21-208.
21-227.
It's not on already, consent.
Right? It's off consent. End.
There it is. Anything else? Now, may I please have a motion and a second to approve the consent agenda with the exceptions of 21-188, 21-182, 21-208.
Bates moves.
Thank you. Mr. Weber?
Seconds.
Mr. Weber seconds. Make sure everybody says their name, please, so that people who are hearing online can hear who's approving. And who wants to speak? Please call the roll.
Okay. Ellen?
Aye.
Bates?
Bates, aye.
Berman?
Berman, yes.
Brown?
Yes.
Davis?
Davis, yes.
Ford?
Yes.
Fraz?
Yes.
Gums?
Gums, yes.
Iqbal?
Iqbal, yes.
Kenyon?
Yes.
Caius?
Caius, yes.
Toby?
Hope yes.
Leonard?
Leonard, yes.
Lewis?
Lewis, yes.
Martin?
Martin, yes.
Molina?
Molina, yes.
Sanchez?
Yes.
Chepro?
Chepro, yes.
Silva?
Silva, yes.
Strathman?
Strathman, yes.
Sturgis?
Sturgis, yes.
Tepe?
Tepe, yes.
Weber?
Yes.
Winicky?
Winicky, yes.
Passes unanimously.
Very good. So may I have a motion and a second to approve 21-182, which was approved or pulled off of the consent agenda?
I'll move it.
Okay, second. Name?
Second, please. My name is Kenyon.
Thank you, Mr. Kenyon. Yes, discussion.
Yeah, thank you, Madam Chair. I just wanted to echo a little bit of what you said regarding farmland protection. We are such a fortunate county to have that program in our county. And when we first started investigating how we could pass a farmland protection program, we had somebody come in from, I believe it was Wisconsin, and they had a program in Wisconsin, and it was a tough road. The farmers at first weren't all 100% in favor of it. In fact, Mr. Kenyon remembers, it was kind of viewed as government, taking hold of farmland, but as the program moved forward and people started signing up for it and became so successful. We've had a waiting list for years and years and years of farmers that want to protect their farmland. And it's such a gift to, in my township alone, I have a family, six generations who want to continue farming. And the gift is it allows the children and the grandchildren and the great-grandchildren to continue farming if that's, what they want to do for the rest of their lives. So we're just very fortunate. So thank you.
Very good.
I remember well when it came about and the farmers were afraid.
Yeah,
We didn't know what the government, nobody trusts the government except when they send us a check.
But anyway,
20 years ago, and what it does is you sell the development rights to your property. So if you had a 400-acre farm, you sell the development rights. And I think like the original one with the Flanders, that was worth $5,000 an acre for 400 acres. And that was a lot of money to them, a real lot of money to any of us. But anyway, so that farm will never be anything but a farm.
Mm-hmm.
Never. And so, and that's the beauty of it. You're saving this land for future generations just to look at and live around.
Mm-hmm.
So with I know the Flanders took their money. They bought land in southern Illinois. They sold the land. They came back and they bought something else and made it bigger. Tom Flanders is running the farm today. So it just guarantees it will be a farm.
Yeah.
And we all have to eat. Even if it's the fake meat or something like that, we have to eat. Fake meat. That's another farm issue. But it's a wonderful thing. And it was part of it was because the federal government in the ag bill had money set aside mm-hmm. and nobody else in Illinois could do it. Mm-hmm. It was like millions of dollars just sitting there just waiting for Kane County to go up and take it. So mm-hmm. That was the beauty of it.
Yeah.
It's free money, Vern. Free money from the federal government.
Yeah. And can I add a little bit to that? It still is a matching program. So the county would put up, the farmland would have to be appraised, and then the county would put up half the funds, and the feds would match those funds. And that's how we were able to move forward with it. And buy more and more land. It's really a gift.
It is a gift.
Yeah.
And from what my understanding is that King County has some of the richest land dirt in the state of Illinois.
Yeah.
So keep on growing.
Always,
Madam Chair Bates.
King County always leads the way, Madam Chairman.
That's true.
Don't ever forget that.
Bates, please.
Yes, Ms. Bates.
I live in the middle of Aurora, a city. But I consider the farmland of Kane County to improve the quality of life for all of us. So this is part of my heart to see that that ag land preserved for farming and green space.
It is a wondrous site and something I know everyone on this board will continue to support.
Madam Chair Shepro?
Yes, Mr. Shepro.
I don't think Mr. Kenny was necessarily advocating fake meat, but I thought that it would be appropriate to acknowledge Barb Winicki, who was been chair for many years of the Farmland Preservation Program, and Mr. Kenny has been a consistent supporter of the program. And while we might talk about free money. In fact, this is an investment in something that once it's gone, you can't ever get it back. I haven't heard of too many developments being converted into farmland. And unlike most of the collar counties that have agricultural zoning, our agricultural zoning was never considered a holding category until we could find a developer to plow it or chop it up. I would think we would recognize Janice and her colleagues at the development department that have been such a constant and faithful advocate for this program for so many years.
Thank you. Any other comments?
Excuse me. Chauncey Kirkland. I live in King County, Pinga Grove. I was just wondering, are there any programs?
Mr. Kirkland, I'm sorry. Your public comment will have to wait just a little while, please. Thank you so much. But thank you for being here. So if there's no other comments, may I have a motion and a second, or the roll call. I'm sorry, the roll call. Yeah. My apologies, roll call.
This is for the roll call on 21-182.
Correct, farmland protection.
Ellen. Bates.
Bates, aye.
Berman.
Berman, yes.
Brown.
Yes.
Davis.
Davis, yes.
Ford.
Yes.
Fraz.
Yes.
Gums.
Gums, yes.
Iqbal.
Iqbal, yes.
Kenyon.
Yes.
Caius?
Caius, yes.
Kopi?
Kopi, yes.
Leonard?
Leonard, yes.
Lewis?
Lewis, yes.
Martin?
Yes.
Molina?
Molina, yes.
Sanchez?
Yes.
Shepro? Shepro?
He's wore out from speaking all that time.
Silva?
Okay, thank you. Hold on, Shepro, yes, and did we skip Sanchez?
No, we have Sanchez, we have Shepro, Silva, Dr. Silva.
Silva, yes, thank you.
Thank you. Strathman?
Strathman, yes.
Sergis? Sergis, yes. Tepe?
In honor, Mr. Kenyon, yes.
Weber?
Weber, yes.
Wernicke?
Yes.
That passes.
Good, thank you. Now, may I please have a motion and a second to approve 21-188, which is the authorizing creation of a mass vaccination fund, initial funding and provision for line of credit.
Berman.
Sanchez moved. Seconds.
Details on that. Or...
Sanchez. Any discussion?
Moved by Berman and
second by Sanchez.
Got it. Okay.
Is there any discussion? Yes.
Just create the line item in the Dan. Budget. This is just an accounting inserting a new line.
Correct. Is Mr.
Onsick
here?
No.
No.
This is Joe Onsick. I'm on the phone.
Oh, Mr. Onsick, could you talk a little bit about this, please? About fund 354?
This creates the fund in which any revenues that will be allocated to this program can be deposited. But more importantly, it's a place to start collecting the expenditures that have already been incurred. And it also then provides initial funding out of savings from the payroll reimbursements from the CARES Act. And it also establishes a provision for a line of credit in the event the expenditures were to exceed the amount of the initial funding, because this is all on a reimbursement basis, so we'll be likely incurring expenses before we receive funding for the expenses. And because the expenses are unknown at this point, this is just a kind of a safety measure to include that line of credit, just to make sure that we'd be able to pay all the bills when they come due before we may be reimbursed by funding.
Thank you.
I guess the real question is Berman. The question is, what are we going to fund with that? And are we going to therefore move everything that can go on?
Mr. Sanchez.
Cannell Snowden is on the line, our public health finance person.
Cannell? Would you like to speak?
I'm sorry, I had stepped away. What was the question?
What's the question?
What is the question? Has the health department allocated any expenses to this budget line before it's been approved?
In terms of spending, I mean, as you know, since the clinics have been open, we have been spending funds.
I'm sorry, I'm having a hard time hearing you. It's distorted, your speaker.
Can you hear me now?
It's a little bit better.
Okay, since the clinics has been open, the health department has been expending funds, actually using the IDPH grant for the support of the clinics. We haven't expended funds from the 354 as of yet, because it's just been established.
I think,
yes.
Cannell, what are the intentions of the fund usage for this?
For 354, which is for the mass vaccinations, our intent is to support the activities related to the clinics, the mass vaccination clinics that are opening and are open.
Okay, so any other funding requests from the health department would come from somewhere else. Is that correct?
For the mass vaccination, we have basically looking at two revenue streams. One is the IDPH grant, which we're using now. The other one is the ARP. We've already received funding from the board approval for the rent. which is in one of our accounts for the rent for the clinics. So those are two we have already. One we are anticipating when those fundings come available to request funds to continue to support the clinics.
Madam Chair?
Yes, Mr. Berman.
Well, the reason this came about was looking for the health department, looking for approval for paying a temporary assignment pay for all employees. And this is something that was granted in the 2020 budget last July, and they were paid from July through December an additional 10-15% of the wages. And of course, the dollars from that came out of their budget. But now they're proposing that same thing for this year, and expecting funding from for it. And I think it just, I'm concerned that either the new board members are not aware of a temporary assignment pay or what the cost of it was in prior budget, but also something that's happening in budget 2021.
Yes.
Again, my original question was just based on, this isn't approving any funding. It's just opening the checkbook and creating a line item to be able to—
Mike, please.
The microphone. And name, please.
Surges, sorry. My original question was simply, I don't believe that this item is funding anything. It's just a ledger entry that allows us to create an account within the accounting system where all of this will begin being tabulated. And that's what I was trying to ascertain. We're not being asked to fund anything today. We're just being asked to create those accounts where the reconciliations will occur.
There is my understanding, and Mr. Onzik can share, there's going to be $500,000 allocated to that fund. So it's not just opening up, it will be funded. And our question is that the TAP money that has been requested by the health department comes to $430,000. They currently, to my understanding, do not have that long-term support for that. And they're looking at getting reimbursed from this with funds that have not yet been realized. I think we need to be fully cognizant of this TAP funding, the temporary emergency funding that goes in for our employees, as well as there was, they've all worked very hard. I mean, I'm not questioning their efforts, especially as I just mentioned what's happening today with our two of our vaccination sites, but it has to go through proper protocol. The board needs to be aware of what these raises are. There's another raise that has been requested that all of you would have to approve. I do not have authorization to approve by a director. Director's increase in her compensation. I don't have the authority to do that. But only you have the authority to do that. So our concern is that if this is, I agree with you, the intent and purpose, to my knowledge, was to the operations of the facility, which could be additional rent that would have to be paid, material supplies, all of the things to keep a facility open. But I'm not sure about the salaries, because simply we would tap out that $500,000 immediately after, if this gets extended onto that. So to me, they're separate items. So why I approve the intent of 21-188, but I don't approve how the salaries are coming about without having all of your input on this.
Madam Chair.
Yes, Mr. Shepro.
Would it perhaps be in order to move to recommit this to the Finance Committee? Because it does seem that there are two separate issues, as Mr. Surges brought up. One is simply creating a line item And the second are the substantive items that you've talked about. And it seems to me that you would, might do one and not, and reserve the others.
Well, there has been no resolution brought to you for these salary increases.
Okay.
So we can approve the 21,888, but any expenditures that are pulled out of that should be approved by the board.
They have to be.
I would withdraw my motion because then I think it is, if I understand Mr. Onzik's comments, it is purely establishing a line item.
If it's kept as simple as that, absolutely. And I would like to ask Mr. Bermel, Berman, what you feel about this.
I think that's fine. I think the idea was just to make the board aware of it and something that we need to consider when we're talking about giving those funds to different departments. Obviously, once it's given to them, they have the right to do whatever they want with it. But I think we need to look at it before. That's all.
Yes.
Thank you, Madam Chair. This is Leonard speaking. My concern is this $400,000, and I may not understand this fully, but from what I've received, a large portion of this $400,000 was for temporary increases in payroll for people in the health department at a rate of somewhere between 10 to 14%.
15.
10 to 15%. And obviously, if we're going to continue in that vein, I think we need a full explanation of exactly what those raises were for the individuals in that department. And then we have to decide as a board whether or not we want to improve that substantial of an increase, or was that just a temporary one-time thing? And if in fact that was a temporary one-time thing, we don't really have to consider it in the future.
Hello, this is Canal.
Hold on just a second, but my understanding is that this is a continuation of that on top of the other raise that they've had, but that is to be discussed.
Yeah, I think that's what I'm saying. We need to define, originally it was, I believe, agreed upon as a temporary increase, and temporary doesn't mean perennial. So I think we have to have that defined better, find out exactly where we're at. I'm very much in favor of putting this resolution approving it. I just want to make sure before we agree to any funding of it, where the money is going and what it's going to be used for.
I agree. Mr. Cannell, yes, please. Hello, Mr. Cannell, do you want to speak?
Yes, correctly so, that this is just a temporary adjustment in pay, similar to what was done last year, that was done in July. And the intent is for it to run for the extent of when our current available funding, our current budget has been exhausted. At that point, we will be asking if the ARP funds are available to be reimbursed for those funds. If not, then as the health department has done in the past and did with the CARES Act funds, end it when we can no longer support those pay adjustments and the rates would go back down to their original amounts.
Well, I think it's prudent, and I think all board members would agree that we have not received the American Recovery money yet. It's coming, but we don't have it in the bank, and we have received no guidance from the Treasury on how that money is to be spent. So it's we know it's coming, but it's not to be touched. And I think we can all agree upon that. We have to wait for guidance from the Treasury before we go ahead and spend this money. So that, I don't want to bank on it, literally, because we cannot. It may be for some other purposes. So it's going to have to be adjusted with monies we have available now. And what I would like to recommend is that with restrictions, knowing on how we're going to use this budget line for 21-88, that we, if you consider passing that, but then hold on to any of the pay raises until the board has a chance to analyze them, and going to the finance committee, if that's acceptable to everybody, and then we can bring it up to our next board meeting for your approval.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a proper Chair, process. Yes.
Madam Chair, Sergis here. Again, my question was not to derail this in any way, but to simply identify, are we just opening this fund for line item purposes? I understand we're putting $500,000 into it. Mm-hmm. This will be where we transactionally do things, but we're not approving anything today in this. This is just opening that account as I'm understanding it, but not being the sharpest tack in the room. I just want to make sure that I understood that, that that's the case. And that's what I'm asking. And I wholeheartedly, if Joe needs this to begin the accounting practice of it, then let's get this tool in his hand and allow him to use it as long as those other questions are coming back through finance.
Excellent.
Fine.
I think this
was a question.
You were just being preemptive as we were with this discussion. So may I please have a
roll call?
Thank you.
This is for 21-188. Ellen. Bates.
Bates, aye.
Berman.
Berman, yes.
Brown.
Yes.
Davis.
Davis, yes.
Ford.
Yes.
Ross.
Yes.
Gums.
Gums, yes.
Iqbal.
Iqbal, yes.
Kenyon.
Yes.
Caius.
Caius, yes.
Kopi.
Kopi, no.
Okay. Leonard.
Leonard, yes.
Lewis.
Lewis, yes.
Martin.
Yes.
Molina.
Molina, yes.
Sanchez.
Yes.
Shepro.
Shepro, yes.
Thank you. Silva.
Silva, yes.
Strathman.
Strathman, yes.
Sergis.
Sergis, yes.
Tepe.
Tepe, yes.
Weber.
Weber, yes.
Wernicke.
Wernicke, yes.
That passes. Motion passes. May I please have a motion and a second to approve Resolution 21-208, finance, approving the February 2021 claims paid.
Sanchez moves.
Sanchez. And second.
By Ellen. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, discussion. Yes.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I just had a question. Joe Ontick is on the line. I would assume he would answer this. In the claims paid, there are a whole bunch of payments made out to Fifth Third Bank, but they're for various different things that I don't think that banks do, like office supplies and employee training. So I was just curious what is behind that, the Fifth Third Bank payments?
Well, this is Joe Onzik. The Fifth Third Bank payments, that's our credit card, our purchasing card. They provide that service. And so to the extent that the purchasing cards are used throughout the county, through all the offices and departments, various purchases are made. You know, normally they're online purchases, and those purchases are paid for with that credit card. The specific items that were purchased using the credit card are normally part of each monthly committee's reports. So all of the offices and departments that report to a specific committee, you'll find within the monthly financial reports we call a P-card report, which shows all of the detail of what was purchased using the credit card. So that's where you would find all the detail behind what these payments are on the claims paid report.
Okay, so is there a way to find out the vendors that are used with the P-cards?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I believe that's part of the report. That's, you know, separate, provided separately to the committees.
Okay, so it shows the actual vendors that get paid for these services?
Yes, it should, but I can double check that for you. I'm just trying to see if I can find one now as we speak.
Easier, Mr. Onzik, I don't know if your office, would you be able to, if you don't have it, would you be able to provide, you know, like a, I don't know if audit is the right term. Is this something the auditor would do? I don't know. So that we can see all the vendors that are being paid out.
Well, I will have to find out how that could be accomplished. I'm sure our purchasing department could obtain such a report since they're the administrators of the program. So we can certainly do that. And I'll also check into what is currently available already for you.
No, don't the original statements reflect the specific item and vendor? On the credit card statement?
And Ms., if I may interrupt, our auditor is here and she's willing to speak on this issue. Ms. Wegman, please.
Yeah, definitely. So we can complete an audit for 2020 if the board would like, and it would show all the vendors and everybody who used their P card for those purchases.
Wouldn't want to create too much trouble for you, too much work.
We can accommodate.
Okay, I would appreciate that if you can. Thank you. And thank you, Jill.
Thank you very much. Does that answer your question?
Yes, it does.
Okay. Is there any other discussion? Hearing none, please call the roll.
Okay. Allen. Bates.
Bates, aye.
Berman.
Berman, yes.
Brown.
Yes.
Davis.
Davis, yes.
Ford.
Yes.
Roz.
Yes.
Gums.
Gums, yes.
Iqbal.
Iqbal, yes.
Kenyon?
Yes.
Caius?
Caius, yes.
Gopi?
Gopi, yes.
Leonard?
Leonard, yes.
Lewis?
Lewis, yes.
Martin?
Yes.
Molina?
Molina, yes.
Sanchez?
Yes.
Shepro?
Yes.
Silva?
Silva, yes.
Strathman?
Strathman, yes.
Sergis?
Sergis, yes.
Tepe?
Tepe, yes.
Weber?
Weber, yes.
Moniki?
Moniki, yes.
Passes.
Thank you. May I have a motion and a second to approve and or discuss and potentially approve amendment to the Kane County Code Chapter 25 zoning ordinance regarding adult use cannabis businesses in the unincorporated area of Kane.
I'll make the motion, Madam Chairman.
And your Kenyon name? Thank you, sir. And a
Bates,
second?
I a second.
Bates, second?
I'll have Bates second.
Okay. Is there any discussion? Hearing no discussion.
Madam
please.
Chair?
Yes.
Yes, I just...
name, please?
Yes, everybody... Shepro.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, yeah. Mr. Shepro.
As you know from previous meetings, I had asked for some procedural consideration here. I appreciate very much the effort of Mr. Martin and his committee. And I think regardless of what one's views might be on the repeal issue, we clearly have to have an ordinance. I think the staff has done a good job. I believe they've accommodated the concerns that some board members have expressed. I will support this ordinance.
Thank you very much. Any other thoughts? Hearing none, please call the roll.
Allen. Bates.
Bates, aye.
Berman.
Berman, yes.
Brown?
Yes.
Davis? Davis? Ford?
Yes.
Roz?
No.
Gums?
Gums, yes.
I'm sorry, Gums?
Yes.
Iqbal?
Iqbal, yes.
Kenyon?
Kenyon, yes.
Caius?
Caius, yes.
Opie?
Opie, no.
Okay. Leonard?
Leonard, yes.
Lewis?
Lewis, yes.
Martin?
Martin, yes.
Molina?
Molina, yes.
Sanchez?
Yes.
Shepro?
Shepro, yes.
Silva?
Silva, yes.
Strathman?
Strathman, yes.
Sergis?
Sergis, yes.
Tepe?
Tepe, yes.
Weber?
Weber, yes.
Winicky?
Winicky, no.
Okay, I just want to confirm the nays on this. I have Fraz as a nay. I have Kopi as a nay. And I have Winicky as a nay.
Got it.
Correct.
That's correct.
Mm-hmm. Motion still passes.
Thank you. May I please have a motion and a second to rescind ordinance number 19-415 and permitting cannabis business establishments within the unincorporated areas of Kane County.
Berman moves.
Gums.
And
Kenyon Gums. Seconds.
It's Mr. Kenyon.
Berman moves. Kenyon seconds.
Ready? Any discussion? Yes.
Madam Chair, there's a procedural necessity. When this was originally tabled, it has a 90-day hiatus in it prior to it being effective. We did that originally in contemplation of the zoning ordinance coming in later. So procedurally, to comply with the administrative aspects of the state communication, I'm blurring this all up, but we need to take out the 90 days and have it be effective immediately.
All right.
So I would move to amend the effective date to be from and after passage and approval.
Sanchez seconds.
Today. Thank you for that clarification.
So that's you're going to amend it?
So we have to amend the date. So we're amending the resolution.
It's going to be effective. The rather than being effective 90 days after passage, it would be effective
for passage.
I think the appropriate term is from and after passage and approval.
Okay.
So I believe we have to take a vote on that amendment, on that change. Can you read what the change would be exactly, and then we can take a vote on it?
Me? No. I don't have the resolution.
Change would be that changing it from a 90-day delay and effective date, the change would be that it will be effective immediately upon passage and approval.
Okay, very good. Roll call.
I'm trying to get that. Okay. Just want to make sure I get it for the record. Absolutely. Okay, this is on the amendment. Ellen. Bates.
Bates, aye.
Berman.
Berman, yes.
Brown.
Yes.
Davis.
Davis, yes.
Cord.
Yes.
Fraz.
Yes.
Gums.
Yes.
Iqbal.
Iqbal, yes.
Kenyon.
Yes.
Caius.
Caius, yes.
Kopi.
Kopi, no.
Leonard.
Leonard, yes.
Lewis.
Lewis, yes.
Martin.
Martin, yes.
Molina.
Molina, yes.
Sanchez.
Yes.
Shepro.
Shepro, yes.
Silva.
Silva, yes.
Strathman.
Strathman, yes.
Sergis.
Sergis, yes.
Tepe.
Tepe, yes.
Weber.
Weber, yes.
Winicky.
Winicky, no.
Okay, I have two nays, Kopi and Winicky.
Okay.
But that passes.
All right, it passes. Now, is there any discussion on ordinance 21-225 as amended?
Madam Chair.
Yes, Mr. Shepro.
I confess to having mixed feelings about this issue. As you know, I'm somewhat of a procedural geek. During the discussions that we have heard from members of the public, for example, it was pointed out by, I think, an advocate for this action that Batavia had a referendum on this issue before they went ahead and passed it. We've heard from board members on similar issues where they have been reminded us that this whole board is taking action that affects one particular district or one particular bridge crossing, despite the perceived views of the members of that area. And so I do have a concern that whatever the merits of the proposal, the residents of the unincorporated areas, whose representatives, along with the entire board, did vote initially to prohibit it in the unincorporated areas. This board, I think, is now about to vote to rescind that. And obviously, many of the members who I believe will vote for that will not have any constituents who reside in the unincorporated areas. But on the other hand, as has been pointed out, the regulatory scheme that is in place does not automatically create any of these establishments. The zoning ordinance that we have just passed does not establish anything. It establishes a framework. And so while I do wish that the residents of the unincorporated areas had the opportunity to weigh in on this, the practical effect of passing this at the moment is to really not change the status quo at all. And so if you're thinking to yourself, well, Shepro's having an argument with himself, you'd probably be correct. But I do feel, I do wish that we had given, had a framework for the voters of those areas to express their views. Thank you.
Thank you. Is there any other discussion?
Just wondering what the outcome of the argument with himself is.
He lost.
Wait until Mr. Sanchez votes.
Mr. Sanchez, you have a comment?
Yeah, I just wanted to say last year when the board voted to not approve these businesses, the common theme and understanding was that we would look at it again the year later to see how things went, because the almost the only concern was the public safety aspect of it. Sheriff Hain was very forthcoming with information that he felt was reasonable. And so the board was hesitant because we didn't know what was gonna happen. I didn't know what was gonna happen. But since then, we had a leap year with COVID, and these cannabis businesses don't attract the crime that some suspected they would. They bring good things to the community. They invest in their community, even just the grow operations. So I just wanted to remind some of the new members that that was really the understanding that led to us saying no last time. It was the public safety side. And now Sheriff Hain has told us there's nothing to worry about, you know, no more than any other kind of establishment. So unlike a toll bridge going through a neighborhood, this is just the opportunity for some honest, hardworking people to open businesses and contribute to our tax base. Thank you.
Exactly. Yes. Oh, hold on, Mr. Kopy.
Fraz speaking. Yeah, in my county board race last fall, my opponent really was a one-issue opponent, one-issue candidate, which was supporting this, and she was soundly defeated. So therefore, I will be not supporting it. And I just will point out that three of the four of us that represent the western half of the county are opposing this, and that represents the vast majority of the unincorporated areas in the county. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Kopy?
Thank you, Madam Chair. The one concern that the sheriff had implemented into the alleged decision-making process by the entire board is not completely accurate. There were other ramifications to be considered, and one of the main points that that stuck in my craw was that we are allowing the wholesale distribution of hallucinogenic drug into our society, and it's obvious the younger people are going to have more access to it than they ever did, and I was raised in a culture that it was a very popular pastime, and it did not do well for a lot of my peers and friends, and it just led on to bigger and bigger things, it's got an effect, whether you want to admit it or not, so it's more than just the sheriff's opinion. It's a moral opinion also, I will oppose it, and I will always oppose it. Thank you.
Yes, Mr. Martin.
To continue Mr. Shepro's argument with himself, and I think bearing up on a couple of the comments that have been made, I think as a board, we need to be cautious about isolating our viewpoint in a way that refers only to our needs. Example being, I think 80% of the county does not receive sheriff patrols because we have police departments in our municipalities. So should we not fund the police or the sheriff's office because they only serve the rural areas? I mean, we have to look at the county as a whole and look upon the general welfare of what we do. And each of us can point out examples of where our district uniquely is not receiving a full financial benefit out of every tax dollar it pays for the activity involved. My district, at least 80% of my district, has police service from the cities of Batavia and Geneva. So should I argue then that we shouldn't fund the sheriff because we don't use him? Mm-hmm. And I've just wasted a minute and a half of everybody's time, but we need to be careful as to how myopic our viewpoint becomes on what serves the benefit of our constituents in our county.
Thank you. And if I may make a point, I was reading, I heard John Boehner in an interview on Sunday, Meet the Press. And after listening to him, I did a little bit more research, and he has changed his opinion on the use of cannabis. He is not a cannabis user, nor am I, but in my reading of his decision of why he supported it, one of the things that I wanted to share with you is that there was a survey done of our men and women who serve the United States, the military, and many of them have had wounds, injuries, et cetera, through their service. And pain is what pain is. And they celebrated the fact that allowing medical cannabis to be consumed has reduced their consumption of opioids. And then to go further on, it is dramatically linked that if you have medical cannabis, the use of opioids or the overuse of opioids really decreases. And that is something I think we can all get behind, because to Mr. Kopi's point, teenagers sometimes do silly things. We've all done them. We were all at that age at one time, experimented with things that in hindsight, we go, what the heck? But to reduce the illegal sale of opioids on the street, especially for people who need it, who need that pain reduction, to a product that is naturally based, organically based, and highly controlled by the state of Illinois, I think is something to not diminish the importance of what this cannabis industry can do. And we saw from Wabansi's presentation, this is exactly what they'll be looking for. So that's my opinion.
Madam Chair, Sergis, when this was presented last year, I've never smoked marijuana. I don't know much about it. I'm not claiming to in any way, shape, or form. So I had reached out to healthcare professionals, law enforcement, pastors, other community leaders that I represent from Gilbert's, Sleepy Hollow, West Dundee, and East Dundee. I think that each of those municipalities did an excellent job of protecting the schools and children and religious institutions in the way that they put things forward. So when it came to the county, my major concern was what Sheriff Hain had to say and how he could, and he put, you know, he did a very nice graph and said this is the areas that he was worried about. In conversation with Sheriff Hain a year later now, Ron has come right out and said, we just haven't had any problems. We haven't been called in. We're not, you know, coming to the rescue here or there. So for me, I am flip-flopping my vote immediately, you know, admittedly, to say I voted against it last year. We now have data coming through this year. I'm in favor of this as long as we are protecting those areas, and I believe we have, within churches or schools sites, as to how, you know, how close we, you know, a facility could be in those areas. So just my two cents.
Thank you.
Madam Chair.
Yes.
You know, I've had probably more direct experience with the sale of cannabis to the village of North Aurora. And we first went into it with the medical marijuana. And of course we approved the recreational marijuana. I think we're concerned with comments about the youth. You still have to be 21 to purchase, no matter what. So if the youth are using it, they're finding some way of procuring it, whether it be legally or illegally, whatever. And I think that one of the things that we talk about, and all we talk about, is the smoking of marijuana. But I don't know the percentage of what is sold in the way of tobacco use or gummy bears or whatever, but there's a great number of people, adults, that are using marijuana in more of a medical kind of situation, using it to help them sleep, using that to help them relax. So there's many more uses to it from the standpoint of a drug. There's so many other drugs that are being sold to the drugstore. So I think we look at it as something that we worry about the youth more than anything else, but it's not something that is proven, at least in the village's standpoint, that we certainly have any increase in traffic violations or whatever due to cannabis. So I think that what we're doing is right in rescinding what we had agreed upon years ago. So I speak in favor.
Thank you. Any other comments? If none, please call the roll.
Okay, this is for 21-225 as amended. Allen? Bates,
aye.
Berman,
yes.
Brown?
Yes.
Davis,
yes.
Ford?
Yes.
Fraz?
No.
Gums, yes.
Iqbal, yes.
Kenyon?
Yes.
Caius,
yes.
Kopi,
no.
Leonard,
yes.
Lewis, yes.
Martin,
yes.
Molina,
yes.
Sanchez?
Yes.
Shepro?
Present.
I'm sorry, Shepro?
Present.
Oh, thank you. Silva?
He lost.
Silva, yes.
Strathman?
Strathman, yes.
Sergis,
yes.
Tepe,
yes.
Weber, yes.
Wegman? I'm sorry. Wonicki?
Wonicki, no.
Okay. And I've got three nays on that, Fraz, Kopi, and Wonicki. Okay, passes. One person, correct.
Depro's argument was a draw.
Passes.
The motion. The
motion passes. Congratulations for all of you supporting a new business industry that I think is going to provide not only financial resources, but scientific resources here to Kane County, as well as celebrating and continue the celebration of our farm and our agricultural business. May I have a motion to approve number 21-226? Adopting an FY21 budget for 21 budget for the emergency rental assistance program.
Sanchez moves.
Thank you. Berman second.
Second.
Oh. Everyone wants to. Wants to second it. We all second this.
Berman. I have Berman as second. Ending that. Any discussion? What a great program.
You're all talked out.
You're all talked out.
I wonder how we can get any services from anybody for $9.
For $9.
There he is.
I did get a phone call from a woman yesterday who was kind of a sad story. Of course, I won't use any names. She is in the hospital right now, recovering from COVID, and she's had some damage done to her lungs, so she's going to be going into nursing care. And she asked me to make sure that I took down her name and her information, so once this gets passed and authorized, she can be put on the list so that she can have an application to receive the rental program. And this is exactly what this program is for. If there's no other discussion, can you please call the roll?
Ellen?
Aye.
Bates?
Bates, aye.
Berman?
Berman, yes.
Brown?
Yes.
Davis?
Davis, yes.
Ford?
Yes.
Fraz?
Yes.
Gums?
Yes.
Iqbal?
Iqbal, yes.
Kenyon?
Yes.
Tyus?
Tyus, yes.
Kopi?
Kopi, yes.
Leonard?
Leonard, yes.
Lewis?
Lewis, yes.
Martin?
Martin, yes.
Molina?
Molina, yes.
Sanchez?
Yes.
Shepro?
Yes.
Silva?
Silva, yes.
Strathman?
Strathman, yes.
Sergis?
Sergis, yes.
Tepe?
Abstain.
Weber.
Weber, yes.
Wanicki.
Wanicki, yes.
That passes. Oh, very good. Well done. May I have a motion and a second authorizing the creation of a toll bridge sales tax revenue fund, which is fund number 306, a toll bridge operating fund number 307,
so and the
toll bridge renewal fund number 308.
Move by searches.
Mr. Fraz.
Fraz moves.
And who is
Tepe second.
Tepe.
Oh, okay.
Is there any discussion on this? Yes.
Madam Chairman Kayas. Mm-hmm. Just trying to figure out how to draw out this discussion about creating a fund that doesn't really do anything except collect money about an area that is represented county, but that is opposed by my end of the county, which is all the arguments we just had over and over again. Mm-hmm. Just to be short, brief, I will be voting no on this. While it is just the creation of a fund, I want to remind the board that I hope that you keep in mind that this is a sunsetted item and that we should work to have this item removed from our system, the toll on the bridge, the Long Meadow Parkway, as soon as possible. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other discussion? Hearing none, please call the roll.
Allen? Bates?
Bates, no.
Berman?
Berman, yes.
Brown?
Yes.
Davis?
Davis, yes.
Ford?
Yes.
Fraz?
Yes.
Gums?
Gums, yes.
Iqbal?
Iqbal, yes.
Kenyon?
Yes.
Tyus?
Kayas, no.
Kopi?
Kopi, yes.
Leonard?
Leonard, yes.
Lewis?
Lewis, yes.
Martin?
Martin, yes.
Molina?
Molina, yes.
Sanchez?
No.
Shepro?
Shepro, yes.
Silva?
Silva, yes.
Strathman?
Strathman, no.
Sergis?
Tepe? Tepe, yes.
Weber?
Weber, yes.
Wanicki?
Wanicki, yes.
That passes. Okay, motion four passes. Okay. Four no's. May I have a motion and a second amending the employee policy handbook? And this is number 21-228.
So moved.
Name?
Sergis.
Shepro second.
Who second?
Shepro.
Shepro. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, please call the roll.
Ellen?
Aye.
Bates?
Bates, aye.
Berman?
Berman, yes.
Brown?
Yes.
Davis?
Davis, yes.
Ford?
Yes.
Roz?
Yes.
Gums?
Yes.
Iqbal?
Iqbal, yes.
Kenyon?
Yes.
Dias?
Dias, yes.
Kopi?
Kopi, yes.
Leonard?
Leonard, yes.
Lewis?
Lewis, yes.
Martin?
Martin, yes.
Molina?
Molina, yes.
Sanchez?
Yes.
Shepro? Shepro? Okay. Silva?
Silva, yes.
Strathman?
Strathman, yes.
Sergis?
Sergis, yes.
Tepe?
Yes.
Weber?
Weber, yes.
Wonicki?
Wonicki, yes.
That passes.
Motion passes.
Was I recorded as a yes on that?
I received nothing.
Okay, my internet connection dropped for a second. I would wish to be recorded, yes.
Thank you.
Shepro.
Thank you.
It passes.
It does pass. May I have a motion and a second to approve Resolution 21-229, amending the Personal Policy Handbook Section Insurance Benefits?
Sturgis moves.
Eight seconds.
Thank you. Is there any discussion?
No.
Hearing none.
Helen? Bates?
Yes.
Berman?
Berman, yes.
Brown?
Yes.
Davis?
Davis, yes.
Ford?
Yes.
Roz?
Yes.
Gums?
Gums, yeah.
Iqbal?
Iqbal, yes.
Kenyon?
Yes.
Caius?
Caius, yes.
Kopi?
Kopi, yes.
Leonard?
Leonard, yes.
Lewis?
Lewis, yes.
Martin?
Martin, yes.
Molina?
Molina, yes.
Shepro? I'm sorry, Shepro. Sanchez. Shepro?
Shepro, yes.
Silva?
Silva, yes.
Strathman?
Strathman, yes.
Sergis?
Sergis, yes.
Tepe?
Yes.
Weber?
Weber, yes.
Wegman? Wonicki?
Wonicki, yes.
Motion passes. All right. Madam State's Attorney, are we going to any need to go into executive session?
We are, but I also believe that there was the one individual who had the public comment and wasn't able to connect.
Oh, absolutely. Thank you for that. Stand again. Mr. Kirkland, are you still online?
Yes.
Would you like to speak?
I was not at the moment.
Are you sure?
I mean, we passed the ordinance for the cultivation and for cannabis businesses. So that was really what I was listening in for. Other than that, I mean, maybe a public comment that I was thinking is for putting that ordinance, you know, keeping it to that 90 days, because for people trying to get into this business right now, the applications haven't even opened up yet for the state. You know, if we made it available right now, then people who are just getting their applications, well, Kane County has not been on there, but they would basically be able to just move in if they had their license. I think to be more fair to people who are newer and are trying to get in, we need that 90-day ordinance.
Thank you. And I'm sure that you are aware that the licensing has to go through the state of Illinois.
Yes.
We have no authority on that at all.
All right. And then when is the meeting for the tax dollars that's coming in for that, the use of that?
The tax is going to be starting to be collected in May.
All right. And then lastly, are there any programs? I heard about the Farm Protection Program. Are there any programs that would give, you know, people that are trying to get into the farming business, provide land or something of that matter to help them get started?
That you can go to the next meeting of the Agricultural Committee, and I'm sure that they'd be able to address that. And when is that going to be?
Next Thursday.
Next week?
All right, what time?
A week from Thursday at 9 a.m.?
Mm-hmm.
9 a.m.
All right, thank you.
We're at 10. Yeah.
Right?
We are at 10 a.m.
We are.
Public service.
Public service. Public service.
Somebody is.
So if you just, if you call my office, we'll be able to direct you to the proper department chair, and they'll be able to assist you with that.
All right, thank you.
Thank you very much for speaking and for joining us online. It is appreciated.
Well, Madam Chair, for closed session, we'll need to go in for employment matters, discipline issues, performance of specific employees, as well as a pending litigation update.
May I have a motion and a second to go into executive session?
Shepro, so moves.
Shepro, Mr.
Thumbs
Shepro.
Second.
Thumbs.
Thumbs second.
We are in executive session.
Vote.
We have to vote. My apologies, of course. Well,
one step at a time.
Step at a time.
Allen. Bates.
Bates, aye.
Berman.
Berman, yes.
Brown.
Yes.
Davis.
Davis, yes.
Ford.
Yes.
Fraz.
Yes.
Gums.
Gums, yes.
Iqbal.
Iqbal, yes.
Kenyon.
Yes.
Caius.
Caius, yes.
Kopi.
Kopi, yes.
Hunter?
Yes.
Lewis?
Lewis, yes.
Martin?
Martin, yes.
Molina?
Molina, yes.
Sanchez?
Yes.
Shepro?
Shepro, yes.
Silva?
Silva, yes.
Strathman?
Strathman, yes.
Sergis? Tepe?
Tepe, yes.
Weber, yes.
And Winicky?
Winicky, yes.
We are in executive session. We are now in open session. Clerk, can you please call the roll?
Roll call. Allen. Bates.
Here.
Berman.
Berman here.
Brown.
Here.
Davis.
Davis here.
Ford. Fraz.
Here.
Gums.
Gums here.
Iqbal.
Iqbal present.
Kenyon.
Here.
Caius.
Caius present.
Kopi.
Is here.
Leonard.
Leonard here.
Lewis.
Lewis here.
Martin.
Martin present.
Molina.
Molina present.
Sanchez.
Here.
Shepro.
Shepro present.
Silva.
Silva present.
Strathman.
Strathman here.
Sergis. Tepe.
Tepe here.
Weber.
Here.
Winicky.
Winicky present.
We have a quorum.
Very good. Before we adjourn, I just would like to briefly remind the board members regarding the two special board meetings this month concerning the reapportionment. The first one will be on April 21st at 3 p.m. and the other is April 27th at 3:30 p.m. We do have maps up at the conference room upstairs from 2000 and 2010 to see how the districts have changed. And of course, your current map is up there as well with all of your names and where you are. So you can feel free to go upstairs and take a look at those maps. And as we develop new mapping for you, we'll absolutely have that available for your review as well. May I please have a motion to adjourn to May 11th?
Kenyon would like to adjourn this very quick meeting we had. Never.
Second, Berman.
Do I have a second? We have a motion and a second. All in favor? Aye.
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 Any opposition? No. Okay, very good. Thank you all.